Hi, here's a market structure or market forms we are going to discuss here first. You can see the market forms. The type of market depends on the degree of competition prevailing in the market. If broadly classifies, there are two types of competition prevailing in the market. How much competition is there in the market depends on that one. We can divide the market into two forms. They are perfect competitive markets or perfect competition and monopoly. This is what we are going to discuss today. First, perfect competition. Perfect competition is a market situation where many small firms exits. Large number of small firms will prevail or exist in the perfect competition. That's one of the most important feature of this type of market form. Next, single seller or buyer cannot influence the market price by increase or decrease his purchasing or selling. Single buyer or seller cannot influence the market. Next, best use of the resources, as many competing firms are there existing. That's the thing. Many firms are there in the market. As a result, resources will be best utilized. There is not much wastage of these resources. Next, firms provide best quality goods at a low price will success. How much quality goods can provide at a cheap price is one of the criteria to assess the success of the firms in the perfect competition. And high level of competition can be seen. There is so many small firms are there, as a result, competition also will be very high. Next, we are going to see the features of perfect competition. The first feature is price takers. You see, this is one of the most important feature of price takers. As there are many buyers and sellers in the market, no single firm or no single buyer or seller can influence the market price. They have to accept the price decided by the market forces. It is known as price takers. The prices in the market are perfect competition decided by the market forces. The firms have to accept or follow the price which is decided by the market forces, like demand and supply. Single firm don't have any influence on the prices. Next feature is homogeneous products. Each firm's product is a perfect substitute of other firms' products in the industry. Demand for the product is perfectly elastic, and the demand curve is a horizontal straight line. That's the thing. Products are same or homogeneous because same products making, so many firms will be there. So all firms will make the same products. So products will be same or homogeneous. One firm's product can be used in place of other firms. One firm's, each one's products are substitutes, that mean. Next one is some free entry and exit. There is no restriction to the firms to enter and enter into and exit from the market. All firms will make just normal profits. All firms are free to come and start business, and if they are not making profit or entry, so if they want to quit, they can quit freely. There is no restriction, no barriers to entry in the perfect competitive market. Next is some perfect knowledge you are going to see here. Perfect knowledge about the market. That means all the buyers will know about the price of the products, sales. Regarding what the buyers have to know the products, buyers have the perfect knowledge. At the same time, the sellers will have all the information on the latest production technologies, and regarding the products, sellers also will have the production techniques, and about the products, sellers also will have the perfect knowledge idea. Next, free mobility of factors of production. That's the next feature. That means mobility is essential to adjust the supply to the demand. Supply and demand have to adjust to attain equilibrium. So to adjust this demand and supply, mobility of factors of production or resources are highly essential. If any place in the market, if excess demand means that requires to move additional factors into that particular area. That's it. Next, and how to move out when there is an excess supply. If excess demand is prevailing in the market, factors of production have to bring into that particular area. If there is excess supply, how to move out the resources or factors of production from that particular market. So movement of factors of production is essential in this market. This mobility is essential to achieve the equilibrium position. Then only demand and supply will be equal and can attain equilibrium by the firms. So mobility of factors of production is essential to achieve equilibrium position in the markets. Thank you.